And Thomas back out there for the Leafs against this Holik, McKay, and Brylin line. It comes to Sundin. Up on the right side for Thomas. Gains the zone. Sends it across now for Roberts. Roberts sends it deep. There is Sundin. Sundin looking in front, hanging out of the puck. It comes all the way to the point. Hockey Berg shot is blocked. And back comes Brylin. Berg has the angle on him, and he's also got Corey Cross helping. Late man coming. It's Holik to the back. It's it. We talked about Sergei Brylin having the ability to make a play, but Toronto was dangerous with their most dangerous line moments before that.
Well, that pass was originally intended for Gary Roberts from Sundin. It got to Berg. His shot got blocked, and the Devils got the odd man rush, and Randy McKay, I believe that's his first shot on goal of the playoffs, but boy, does he make it count. Right here, it comes across the front of the crease, and Curtis is over there, but he gets it up and over the leg. Let's take a look at the reaction of the New Jersey bench. And there's two old foes that are now two great teammates, Robinson and Fedosov.
The 10th odd-man rush for the Devils in the game results in the game-winning goal. The final score in overtime, the Devils 6 and the Toronto Maple Leafs 5. Our next National Hockey Night telecast coming your way tomorrow at 7:30 on ESPN2 from Reunion Arena, Game 2 between the Blues and the Stars. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com. Baseball Tonight is coming up next. For Neil Smith and Dave Ryan and the rest of our crew, I'm Dave Strader. Thanks for watching. The final score again in overtime on the goal by Randy McKay, the Devils 6 and the Maple Leafs 5.